welcome, it's Smigren here. So this is Warcraft Total War. I released a new version today. It's, I believe, yesterday actually. So the clock is 24:30 night time. So it's a new day. I believe it's Wednesday. So I released a new version of Warcraft Total War on Tuesday, the 5th in April 2000. Tuesday the 4th on April 2021. Okay, so there are two campaigns in this mod. You have the Frozen Throne and the Reign of Chaos campaign. Don't dare clicking on the Frozen Throne campaign now because we have already entered the Reign of Chaos one. Okay, but it could work fine. Well, we could try. Might crash. Alright, this is the Frozen Throne campaign, and the other campaign is the Reign of Chaos campaign. Now I don't dare going back, it might crash actually. Okay. So there are different factions available depending on which campaign you play. The other campaign is the Warcraft 3 campaign, the Reign of Chaos campaign. And this is the Frozen Throne campaign. So this campaign is set after the other one, and is starting at a later date. The map here is inaccurate. It won't show the true starting positions of the Frozen Throne campaign. I believe they are mostly the same as in the Reign of Chaos campaign on this map. That's because Sylphurion made the art of this mod, and the Frozen Throne campaign were added after he quit. So that's why the map is not updated. I have, I believe, added some different colors for the Blood Elves and the Forsaken. Added the Blood Elven color here, but they don't have all of this area. I believe they only have to this point, I believe. And the Forsaken, they have only Lordaeron and Bryll at the start, but I recolored the entire area to remove the Lordaeron colors. I believe most of Lordaeron is held by the Scourge, and only a small bit is held by the Forsaken. And then the Scarlet Crusade is holding at least the Heartglen and the Tear's Hand. Okay, so in the new version, we have changed some stuff. So in the past, the Blood Elves and the Forsaken were only playable in the Frozen Throne campaign. That's still the case. They spawn late game in the Reign of Chaos campaign and are AI controlled in that campaign. They spawn if, I believe the Blood Elves spawn if Kveldhlass only has one region left. And I believe that the Forsaken spawn if Lordaeron only has 5 regions left. Okay. In the previous versions, the Scarlet Crusade and the Naga and the Scarlet Crusade, they used to be playable in the Reign of Chaos campaign as well. But they are no longer playable in that campaign. They are unique to this campaign. And unlike the Sindori or Blood Elves and the Forsaken, they won't spawn in the other campaign either. So they are unique to the Frozen Throne campaign. The other factions are available in both campaigns. The Kingdom of Kveldhlass, which is the Blood Elves before they became Blood Elves, they are no longer a part of the Frozen Throne campaign. So if you want to play as the High Elves, you need to play the Blood Elves in this campaign. In the past they were a part of this campaign under Varisa, but she has been moved to the Blood Elves here. Okay. And in the other campaign, the Reign of Chaos campaign, you can play as the High Elves, and instead the Blood Elves won't be available. Because it's the same faction, just at a different date. It's true that Varisa Windrunner, who is the sister of Sylvanas Windrunner, the leader of the Forsaken, by the way, it's true that she would not be a part of the Blood Elves later and would lead her own little group of High Elves in Dalaran that are allied to the Alliance, but this is set before the Wrath of the Lich King, which is the setting where Varisa would command a small group of fire elves in Dalaran. So it was wrong to have her in Dalaran with three high elves. I believe it's more correct to have her be a part of the Blood Elves during the Frozen Throne. Okay, so I wanted to start a high elven campaign, but now I don't dare go back to the other campaign. It will probably crash when I click on the Reign of Chaos campaign. So we could try a different faction. I was kind of interested in trying out the Trade Coalition, the Goblins. I haven't finished their strat models though, so that's a little boring. I haven't finished that. We're going to play a cooperative campaign between the Sindori Blood Elves and the Naga. I would play both of them in a hotseat campaign and also use the immersion mode to control heroes in battles. But I wanted to finish the mod first, or make it as good as I could make it before playing that campaign. But I've done a lot on the mod already, and I've released a new version recently, and I don't want to do more before playing. I might postpone the Naga and Blood Elven hotseat campaign because I want to finish the rest of the strat models for the humans, the insects, and the dwarves, the goblins, and the trolls. But for now, I just want to play some. That's why I probably won't play the Naga and the Blood Elves now, because I want to save that for when the mod is entirely ready, when all the strat models have been made, when I've implemented the agents for the rest of the factions and added their custom heroes. Then I will play the Blood Elves and the Naga in a cooperative campaign, but here I control both of them. But for now, let's play someone else. I was going to play as the Kingdom of Kvelas, like I did in 2018, I believe. I had a campaign with about 18 or so episodes. It was a campaign in April, I believe, of 2018. It was before the mod released publicly, so it didn't have any strat models back then. It had the battle models. It was an older version, so probably not all of the units. And the mod was very different back then. Now they have all their new strat models and stuff. So either I could start the campaign and just exit the main menu and start up the High Elven campaign, or I can start as someone else, like the Goblins. We will start the Goblin campaign because High Elves are very similar to the Blood Elves anyway. I believe this was going to play the Night Elves. I hear that the Great Book of Grudges will play a live campaign soon. He was going to do that a while back, I believe on March 30. He uploaded two videos. I saw the first one at about 15 minutes or 13 minutes, where he made a review of the old version of this mod, and he liked the mod. And then I viewed his entire 5-hour long live stream where he played different factions to check them out and to show the mod to his viewers on YouTube. He is a big channel. Well, he's not huge, but he's big. As an example, this has about 200 followers. I have about 1500 followers because my YouTube channel is old. It's been around since 2010, so for a decade. And then the Great Book of Grudges, he has about 14,000 viewers on the Warcraft video that was 5 hours long. So 14,000, and I get about like 160 maybe on a video or something. Sometimes under 100 and sometimes under 200. If I'm lucky, I can get 300, 400, 500. Of course, some of my videos have had extreme luck and had like 100,000 or 200,000 views, but that's very rare. I believe one of my videos have over 200,000 views, and another one have about 100,000, and then there are a few that have about 80, 60, 40, 50,000, but most of my videos have about 200 viewers, and then there are a few that have like 3,000 and 5,000 and such. But all of the ones with 100,000 plus or 50,000 plus or 20,000 plus, they are old, mostly uploaded in 2010 and 2011. There are some that are uploaded in 2013 or 2017. I believe the latest one was from 2017, I believe. So they are not that recent. Okay. But the Great Book of Grudges, he was going to play a campaign, but he has been swamped with work, so he hasn't had any time to play. But he wrote yesterday that he was going to play. I hadn't heard from him in a month, so... But he said he was going to play soon. I don't know exactly when soon is, but soon. So last I heard, he was going to play the Scarlet Crusade because his viewers voted on a faction and they voted on the Scarlet Crusade. However, that was on the old version. The new version has two different campaigns. The old version also had two different campaigns, but the difference was that when you play them, only the upper part of the Eastern Kingdoms, this area, was changed to the Frozen Throne in the Frozen Throne campaign. Northrend and Kalimdor was exactly the same in both campaigns, and the lower parts of the Eastern Kingdoms were also exactly the same. But now, this entire map is different and updated to the timeline, and Reign of Chaos is entirely different because it's an earlier setting. So you can say that both campaigns are different now, but in the past only the upper region of Eastern Kingdoms were different. And also, in the past you had the High Elves playable in the Frozen Throne campaign, while in the Reign of Chaos campaign you had the Naga and the Scarlet Crusade. So if he was going to play the Scarlet Crusade in the past, he could have played it in both campaigns, but now he can only play the Frozen Throne campaign if he plays the Scarlet Crusade. But I believe he was going to play the Frozen Throne campaign anyway. Okay, we will see if he will play the Scarlet Crusade. They aren't a finished faction. They still lack most of their new strat models that they have planned. That's true for the Trolls, the Trade Coalition, which is the Goblins, the Humans, the Insects, Ankarai, and the Nerubians. And it's true for... yeah, for the Dwarves too, the Dark Irons and the Kasmodan faction. They still need some new agents and some new custom generals on the strategic map or campaign map. But that's it. Okay. I need to go and do something. I have diabetes, and there is a tool that is causing some annoying sound because I probably have high blood pressure or whatever. I need to go and do something. See you soon. So I'm back. I solved the issue. So when that tool is sounding like that, I have no choice but to go and click on it. And it was in a different room, so I had to go away from the computer and TV screen. Okay, so the Great Book of Grudges, he is a YouTuber with a decent size, and he he will get about 40,000 views per video. Okay, he was going to play the Scarlet Crusade because his viewers voted on them. So the Scarlet Crusade isn't their finished faction. They still lack their planned strat models, as I said. But also I plan on possibly remaking some of the human factions. So Band Chieftain made the base model Footman and the base model Knight of the Stormwind faction. Then Eugen Wolfkin, another modeler, it was active in 2017. He made the entire human rosters out of these two models that Band Chieftain made. So Band Chieftain made two models and Eugen Wolfkin made an entire army out of them, or at least seven units. Then of course there are some WoW models and fan-made models also added to the human factions, mostly the elite units. But Stormwind's army is the unique, Stormwind's army is the original one. So the models that Band made were Stormwind models. And then Eugen expanded on them and made seven units out of two models, one knight and one footman. And then we made their skins, Warcraft Heroes, Furion, etc. They made their skins, so we got Terramore, we got Kingdom of Stromgarde, we got Scarlet Crusade, and the Kingdom of Lordaeron. And Terramore, of course, if I didn't say that. And then we had some minor factions like Kel'Thras, Gil'Nas, Alterac, and Dalaran. We are going to remove most of the minor kingdoms units because we want those slots in order to add, be able to add new troops. So there is a 500 unit limit in the game. We have already reached it. So Stormwind has seven models, and then there are skins of those models in use by Lordaeron, Terramore, Stromgarde, and the Scarlet Crusade. To add to that, they also have a bunch of unique elite troops. So, and maybe one or two unique militias or unique medium troops. But my point is that I can't just remove the units from Terramore, Lordaeron, Stromgarde, or Skull Crusade, because they are just skins, they don't take up a slot. Need to remove the unit from all of the factions in order to open up slot. That's why that's not a good idea. So if I want to, for example, have different units for the Kingdom of Stromgarde compared to Lordaeron, Terramore, Stormwind, or the Scarlet Crusade, then I need to remove something else, then and not the Footman, etc. So we have a lot of ships in the game. Ships in medieval Total War are only on the strat map. You don't really need four or five ships per faction or per race. So I'm thinking of removing most of the ships and only keep two, or one or two ships will be kept per race. By removing the ships, we will open up slots for new units, so that I can remove the clones of Bandus and Eugen's humans from Stromgarde and the Scarlet Crusade, and possibly even from Lordaeron and maybe Terramore. But I promise I will at least do it to the Kingdom of Stromgarde and to the Scarlet Crusade, and then if I can make room for it, I will also change Lordaeron. And then Terramore and Stormwind are unlikely to be changed, but in the best possible scenario I would change Terramore too. So Stormwind will still have their roster that Bant and Eugen made, because if you look at the units you see that the Stormwind ones are the originals. They have a lion symbol on the shield, and it's not a painting. So if you look closely enough on Lordaeron's shields, or the footmen of Lordaeron, or the footmen of the Stromgarde, etc., they have the lion behind the symbol of their faction, because it's not a painting, it's like part of the shield. So the models are Stormwind models, and then I believe Warcraft Hero and Sephurion just painted over them with skins. So that's why it's fine, in my opinion, to replace the clones and add actual units with textures from WoW. The militia units of the human factions are WoW humans, men, women, and you can use actual skins from WoW Classic that will give them armor and such, plate, leather, or just clothes. So with the help of skins, I could just add WoW humans, well, Warcraft humans to the other factions, but I need room. So I will remove a lot of ships on the campaign map, because they take up slots from units, and then we will also remove the most of the Argent Dawn, Kul'Thras, Gil'Nes and Alterac humans. We'll keep the elites, for example Gil'Nes will keep the Gil'Nen claymores, but lose everything else. Dalaran will keep their mages, but will lose all their ordinary knights and cavalry and footmen. And then Alterac will lose probably all of their units, but will get a pike unit. And then Kul'Thras will keep their marines, but lose everything else. Okay. That way we will open up quite a few slots, so that we can create a new roster for the Kingdom of Stromgarde and a new roster for the Scarlet Crusade. They will still keep all their elites, but their basic and medium troops will be different. Either they will be from World of Warcraft, or they will be fan-made professional models and not clones of the Stormwind troops. Stormwind will hopefully become the only one with the old units. That won't prevent me from adding one or two WoW models to Stormwind 2 if there is room for it. I have the textures. It's easier to get Stormwind's textures than to get Lordaeron's. Lordaeron's is the hardest to get. But I believe Scarlet Crusade, they have some models that are Lordaeron models. They're elites, but with different skins. So if we find the original skins, we could add those models to Lordaeron instead of their current models. Okay, so we're going to play as the Goblins. I think they are selected now. We have no battle time limit. We'll manage all the cities. I won't disable the console, I like the console. We won't show, actually we could have show CPU moves. It's actually fun to see the moves of the CPU. Okay, battle difficulty. Could have it on very hard. Have both of these on very hard. I know very hard difficulty in battle means they will get bonuses. So if you are even in a battle, they will win because their units will get experience points. But I think it's fair because we're the players, we're smarter. I don't want to place the Blood Elves or anyone else. I don't know if we have anyone else selected. If we have that, we'll need to exit. Okay, but we will start as the Trade Coalition. Strengths. It's a strong mix of elite, ranged and mechanized units. Weaknesses. Few in numbers, spread out and in need of mercenaries. Their best unit is the Shredder, this guy, the mechanized guy here. Okay, to win we need to hold 50 regions. This is the long campaign. So we need to hold 50 regions, eliminate factions, the Faraki, the Gurbash and Ankirai. Maybe we should play this short campaign. Then we need to hold 30 regions, eliminate factions, the Faraki and the Gurbash. Otherwise we will have to fight Ankirai as well. Hold 20 more regions. I think we will go for the 30 regions. And it's enough to fight the trolls. Okay, the trade collision 616 after the dark portal. I'm not sure if the year is correct in the Frozen Throne campaign. It's correct probably in the Reign of Chaos at least. So the trade collision, I'm not sure if we updated the date here. Okay, the trade, so this is their leader, Fatto. He doesn't have a unique model. So the trade collision, their capital is an isle around here. Then they have areas in Kalimdor, they have Booty Bay in EK, Mystic Kingdoms, and they have Venture Bay in Northrend. In Kalimdor they have, I believe they have Gadgistan over here, they have Mud Sprocket close to Terramor, they have Ratchet close to the Horde, they have Everlook or Evermore, I think it's Everlook over here next to the Night Elves. Okay, the Trade Coalition is the Goblins Merchant Empire. It is ruled by all five of Undermind's trade princes. It is huge, far-reaching, and massively complicated. It commands the trade fleet. The Trade Coalition condones smuggling and slavery. Undermind contains the headquarters of the Trade Coalition. So the capital is Undermind. The Trade Coalition has little influence over Ravelgas, and indeed the raiders attempt to go under, above, and around the Coalition's head. Goblin barons are allegedly there to serve as magistrate over the land and holdings owned by a trade prince. The five, more or less, trade princes collectively control the Trade Coalition. Run by Undermind's trade princes, the Trade Coalition controls much of the commerce throughout the world. Trade Prince Steamweedle, the richest non-goblin on Azeroth, runs the shipping division practically on his own. Ratchet is the chaotic urban center of the Empire of the Trade Princes. Steamweedle Cartel. Prior to the First War, the goblins of the Steamweedle Cartel managed to drive out the trolls from a small port town inhabited by humans which had been overrun. They claimed control of the immediate area and the shores of the cove for their new center for operations in the Eastern Kingdom's Booty Bay. During the war, goblins witnessed the Old Horde's arrival and the conquest of Stormwind. With more conflicts in the horizon, they were determined to profit from it. Trade Prince Steamweedle allied his cartel with Orgrim Doomhammer's Horde and offered aid in form of new technologies, maps, and other useful information to the Orcs for the right price. Orgrim treated his new allies as equals and paid them gold from Stormwind's coffers. The warchief also hired them to oversee the construction of the Horde's fleet. The cartel also sold them the employees of their alchemists, sappers, and zeppelins, also providing the watertight pilot tracks for use on the enslaved giant sea turtles. However, following the war, Steamweedle Cartel and other goblins realized that it was much better to remain neutral due to thriving trades. Approximately 4 years after the Second War, the goblin city of Gadgesan had already been built in tanneries on Kalimdor, as it was visited by Graydon Thorn. Steamweedle Cartel is one of the largest and most successful of the goblin cartels in the Undermine. It is a neutral organization that controls several cities and towns around the world and has allied themselves with a number of other groups such as the Blackwater Raiders in Boot Bay. The Steamweedle Cartel has made a great deal of profit from maintaining neutrality in the conflict between the Horde and the Alliance. Their services are always available to the highest bidder, employing anyone regardless of their affiliation if they can use results. Okay, I think we'll start the game. Alright, so we haven't finished the agents of this faction, which is a little boring. They have most of their agents done. I plan on giving them a Goblin Warlock as the priest, and the Goblin Death Stealers, the like assassin women. I will make that assassin. Otherwise they have all their agents already. Okay, as for their leaders, there are no modules for the fat goblins, so they won't get any custom leaders. Unless I make an elite unit a custom leader. Okay, so we can see that they have some areas on the map. They have undermine here. It's some buildings, we have a great hall. It provides public order bonus due to law 5%, public health bonus 5%, enables recruitment of diplomats, so we can recruit diplomats from the start in the Frozen Throne campaign. The honor hall provides public order bonus due to law 15%, enables training of quite a few units, goblin rabble, goblin infantry, goblin bruiser, tinkers, goblin death dealers, goblin shredders, hobgoblins, hobgoblins bodyguard, sappers, goblin tail gunners, goblin artificer, goblin warlocks, trike gang, and goblin rockets. So we have quite late units here in the capital of Undermine. We have access to a lot of units, not their best units, but almost. We don't have access to the giants, but most other things. Okay, can start with building some paved roads here to increase the economy. We'll do that in every city. So we have an army in Undermine as well. So we have Trade Prince Jastor in Undermine. We have one unit of Goblin Death Dealers, an elite unit. And the elite infantry unit, we have one unit of Tinkers, another elite infantry unit. Then we have two medium troops, we have the Goblin Bruisers, two of them. Then we have two Goblin Infantry, heavily armed goblins, shield and sword or axe, I believe they have both. And then we have the simple troops, we have the Goblin Tail Gunners, their worst gunner. And we have the Goblin Rabble, their militia. Then we have a cannon, Goblin Bombard, which is carried around by, or dragged around by, Rabble. Okay. So I've added temporary portraits to the agents. They are using the Goblin Rabble portrait. Because they aren't finished yet, they will use the same portraits as the units, unless I make them different to differentiate them from the actual units. For now, they are just using the rabble. Okay, we can check the faction. Capital city is Undermine. Faction leader is Trade Prince Jastor, who resides in Undermine. Greatest general is also Trade Prince Jastor. We have 7 generals and we control 7 regions, we have 7 cities and 0 castles. We have won 0 battles and lost 0 battles. The year is 616 after the Dark Portal. It might be wrong because this is the Frozen Throne campaign and I don't know if I updated that. Okay, victory condition, domination all 30 regions. In order to win, and we need to eliminate the factions, the Faraki Trolls and the Gurbashi Trolls. So the Faraki Trolls start outside of Gadgetzan over here. They start in this little pocket, they have one area from the start. And then the Gurbash Trolls, they start outside of Booty Bay, over here. In this campaign they have a lot of areas, they have like all their areas, but there are some, I believe there are 2 or 3 Ogre areas that they do not hold. Then we have Stormwind over here, they have everything here. But the Trolls, they have 4 armies or something, and they have all their areas. They are stronger than we are in this region. We have a full-size army in Booty Bay, but we will defend. Let's build some roads in Booty Bay as well. Some roads in every area. Go for roads in Tanneris, Gadgetzan, and in Everlook. So it was Everlook, I see. And in Ratchet, some roads. Mud's Rocket. So the Trade Coalition or the Goblins, they share buildings and trip models with the Horde. Okay. I choose the Horde of the Dark Horde, because the alliance with the Dark Horde is already ended in the Third War, while they are about to join the Horde in World of Warcraft, so that's why I felt it was more natural for them to be like the Horde, especially since they have the biggest presence in Kalimdor, just like the Horde. Here we have the Night Elves, Maeve's Shadow Song with Unique Model. She also has Unique Model in battle, but that she always had that. Okay, diplomacy. We are allied to the Stormwind faction, the Terramore, the Kasmodan, the Dwarves, the Dark Iron Dwarves, the Evil Dwarves, the Dark Horde, the Night Elves, and the Horde. The reason we are allied to all of them is because if we were only allied to the Alliance, then we would have to fight the other side, or if we were only allied to Horde, we would fight the other side. If we were allied to only some of them, we would be dragged into a decision if we want to stay allied with someone, or declare war, or break the alliance or something. And I didn't want that. In this game, if you are neutral to a faction, then they will most likely attack you. If you are at war, they will also attack you, but if you are allied, they won't. Most of the time they can betray you, but it's less likely to happen. So the closest thing to being neutral is being allied. So if you want the trade coalition to not fight the alliance or the Horde, then the best thing we can do is having them allied to both. By having them allied to both the Dwarven factions from the start, that means their wars won't affect them, because they are already fighting and we are allied to both. Same if the Alliance would fight the Horde, but in the Frozen Throne campaign I believe the Horde is now allied to the Terramore faction and to the Night Elves, because their enemies are the Naga and the Burning Legion, and later the Kirai faction. So that's why they are not fighting in this campaign. In the Reign of Chaos campaign, the Horde will be fighting the Terramore and the Night Elves factions. Okay. So we have the biggest fleet in the world at the start. We still haven't added any portraits for the Goblin submarines. They have the largest fleet, just like in lore. They have one fleet at every city port. I believe Everlook didn't have a port. They have one in Northrend as well. Here we also have the Scarlet Crusade, their fleet. They are neutral to us, we don't have to attack them. They are not allied, so they will probably attack us, but for now we are not in the war. I have also disabled the rebels, by the way, or made them very rare. I increased, I believe, the chances of them spawning to 9,999, which is the less likely. If you place it very high, they are very unlikely to spawn. Can happen, but it rarely happens. I did it for both the pirate ships and the ordinary garrisons, because the ships are just annoying and stinking, the ships of the AI factions and the player, so I didn't want any pirate ships. And when it comes to the garrisons that spawn, they are like 3 or 4 or 5 units. It's not a challenge for the player, and it's just annoying. The AI will also easily handle them. They are just an annoyance. I spent a lot of time in 2018 or something adding all those rebels in every area, etc. But at the end of the day, they are just annoying. I played the Heretical War Classic Ultimate, and that mod deactivated all the rebel spawns, and I found it more fun without the rebels. Okay, let's see what we can do here. So we have some money. I don't know if we have too much money or not. We will have to play and see how it is, how it feels. Okay, so we can recruit units only in Undermine at the start of the game. So I do not have any agents either. We could recruit a diplomat and a merchant. And we could use some units. Could use goblin shredders, maybe. You won't do anything in the other areas. We'll just hold areas. You can see that we have some different sizes. But we have almost full armies or full armies, so we can hold. We have a town. Gadisan is a town. Malsprocket is another town. We have lots of towns. Ratchis is a town. Everlook is a town as well. And Venture Bay is a town. So we have lots of towns. They've recently been built. We have a large town in Boot Bay here. So this is a large town, it's better. And then we have Undermine, which is a large city. It's the only really good area. We need to build up some troops. We can attack the rebels on the Isles here. But the Sandlari Trolls here, they are very strong. We won't attack them. We have 20 Trolls, an army. That's because I want it to be a challenge to take it, because when the Trolls take Sulasar, the capital of the Sandlari Trolls, they get access to their units. So that's why it should be a challenge to conquer them. Okay, let's end turn. I fast forwarded. Okay, the princess return. Prince Artus Menethil is back from his journey to Nordren, but he is not the same person anymore. Influenced by a dark sword named Frostmourne, he has turned against his own people and now has joined the ranks of the Scourge. Okay, so yes, Artus has spawned. Candidate for adoption, benefactor, trade prince Jaster, of course. New mission. 15 turns, take rebel settlement. Description, our great nation appears weak, tolerate such insolence from these rebels. Okay, they want us to take Shimmering Flats outside of Gadgetzan.
Your orders, noble one.
Could probably do that. Let's move there.
We shall continue at first light.
So this is the general, the tinker. End of turn report. So, militarily, oh, by the way, we are minus 6,725 in profits. Our total profits are 93,275. We have an income of 26,797 and an expenditure of 33,522. Okay, military. We are the third strongest military in the world, so the Trade Coalition has quite a few troops in the beginning. Scourge is the strongest faction, they have the strongest military, they have the best production, they have the largest population, and they are overall the strongest faction. The Burning Legion has the best financial situation. We are the third in financial as well. We have the third best financial situation. We are the sixth overall strongest faction. We have a small population on 16th place. I don't exactly know how many factions there are in the game. You could check that. 23 factions, excluding the rebels, okay. So 16 is pretty bad. Let's build something. Can build some training grounds. All these areas, we can build the basic troops in all of the towns, and in Boot Bay, the large town. We want some basic troops available. So, because we can only build troops in our capital currently. Okay, and then we can build some units. I believe we could go for for a goblin artificer and some goblin warlocks. Recruitment report, we have a diplomat and a merchant in Undermine. The merchant can just move out. 23 florins here, we'll go for it. The goblins are slightly in the air because they are small, that's an issue with smaller units that they, like the dwarves and the goblins, it's hard to do. I didn't do them. These are made by Bantu, but I have a problem doing small units as well. Okay, everything else is easy to do for me. Okay, we have a diplomat. So this is the goblin diplomat. The suit. Let's board a ship with him, maybe. We have no use for a diplomat in on an island. Okay, and we can move an army with this general. Attack the trolls over here.
Plotting course now, my lord. We shall continue tomorrow, my lord.
Okay. Construction complete. We have new dirt roads in many places. And still marching. Okay. Let's end the turn. General. Relations report. We have poor relations with the Frack Trolls and Ankerai. By the way, who are we at war with? We are at war with the Frack Trolls, Ankerai, and the Gurbash Trolls, and the minor factions from the start. Okay. So, end of turn report. We are now the second militarily strongest faction. Recruitment report, we have Goblin Threaders and Goblin Artificers. Trade decrease. Exister. Gin Whistle feels unappreciated. Okay. We will move towards this isle and attack the trolls there.
Dropping anchor until morning. Yes.
Move another fleet there, so it's not as easily sank. Sunk. Move all the ships there.
This is as far as we go.
Three ships. Can move all of our fleets there. Maybe not that one. We need a fleet over there.
Yes,
can leave the army in Booty Bay. Move the fleet.
Dropping anchor until morning.
Okay. Create some hobgoblins and believe we could also use some sappers.
Yes.
And we used to have like 4 in the army. Can't move anything right now. So we will click next turn then. Okay, we get new generals each turn, it seems. End of turn report. Same as before. Construction report. We have paved roads and undermine. And we have some training grounds. We can finally recruit some troops in other places than undermine. Only the basic stuff. We can recruit their rabble, goblin rabble. 4 attack, 2 charge bonus, 5 total armor, total defense, combat bonus in woods or snow, excellent morale, recharge without orders, good stamina. Goblin infantry 7 attack, 1 charge bonus. Okay, total defense 11. Much better defense, 1 less in charge bonus, but better attack. Can make field wall, combat bonus in woods or snow, excellent morale, recharge without orders, good stamina. Both of them lack descriptions. Yeah, the Trade Collision was the latest faction we added to the game. It was the last one, even later than the Recall. A few months later than the Recall. Relations worse than the Gurubashi, or maybe the Recall were after the Goblins when I think about it. So we have poor relations with the Gurubash trolls. Trade increase. C6, Rasselgrin, heals unappreciated. So we need to attack somewhere. So we will defend in case they attack. We don't need any troops in Booty Bay. Four units. So these two have joined the army. You could also send the two generals.
Yes, my lord. We shall come. Yes. Not in course. Yes, my lord.
Okay. We'll add those troops to the bigger force.
Yes.
Troops in Ratchet can stay there. Move the fleet. This fleet can also move. Okay. Build this building, the crafter's workshop, so we can get the goblin bombard from undermine. And in other areas, could get traveler's lodge. Now we will get the leather tenier, so we get better armor for our troops. And in Everloop we can get the leather tenier, but it gives us heavy mail. Maybe it's better than the other. Maybe not. We'll go for leather teniers in every area. Booty Bay, we can go for a fighting grounds building. Will give us access to the bruisers too. We'll go for it. Okay. We are already recruiting in Undermine. Gadgets, and we can go for a Goblin Infantry unit. And same in Everlook. In Ratchet. And in Mudsprocket. We don't need one in Booty Bay. Don't need one in Venture Bay either, so we have full garrisons there. The army is reaching the Shimmering Flats soon. So instead of Shimmering Flats we have some Silithid Swarmers and other Karaji insects.
Your orders, number one. Yes.
Okay. We will attack with the general, they have no walls. Right, we will save before the battle. They have the general guest here, an orc, but I'm not sure if he's an orc in battle. Maybe Silithid Swarmers, very bad infantry unit, combat bonus in woods or snow, excellent morale, good stamina, fast moving. The Silithid drones, slightly better. We have the slimes, medium unit. Silithid crawlers, clearly medium unit, better than the slimes. And we have the Silithid reavers, also medium unit. So their best one was the Silithid crawlers, with the exception of the bodyguard, Silithid ravagers. Okay, ravagers. So let's save. I usually have two saves, because sometimes the save can get corrupted, so it's good to have two and save overwrite one, and then the next, and then the old one. So you always have one, in case the first one gets corrupted. Okay, so we let the believe we could let the AI control the allied army. Okay, let's fight the battle. Battle map, I will also control the leader, probably myself in the using the immersion one. Okay, so army strength ratio 5-2, so we are clearly superior here. Let's fight the battle on the battle map. Killing your own father and delivering this land to the Scourge, you have passed your final test. The Lich King is pleased with your enthusiasm. Conduce the Darkener, leader of the Dreadlords, to Artas, or Prince Artas. Start deployment. Remove that one. So this is our general, Tinker. He looks good in battle. Okay, doesn't look glitched. We have the Horde village here. From Warhammer, beginning of the end times, one of the few custom settlements for the orcs in the original beginning of the end times mod. Okay, we will tab out and we will go to the VTV folder, we go to mods, then we will go to the third person mod new, then we will click on run application. We will return to the game, and yeah, I can control him. Sometimes it will bug out and won't work, but now it worked, so we will start the game. We are controlling the goblin in third person. We are currently walking. Let's change it to running, so we can switch on V. And on U, G, on U I move forward, on G I move to the left and to the right on E, and back on H. I mean back on J, and to the left on H, and to the right on K, and forward on U, and then change to walking or to running. On V, and I zoomed in on him by clicking on delete. So our army should be reaching the enemy soon. I like this view, it's pretty cool. Need to stay behind. Hurry up with the bodyguard. There's some fighting going on over there. 11% enemies killed already, 12%, 1% allies killed. The bodyguard of the Trade Coalition is the Hobgoblins. The big bodyguard. Fire there, probably from the bombard. He had a bombard in the army. We had no mages or some no such. I believe in our reinforcements that are arriving in the other ship. We have some gunners, artificers, and mages. Not in this army. Back to the hilltop here so you can see power, 30% enemies killed, 30% allies killed. Let's try to go around the enemy, reach our troops. I like the Tinker, it's like a cool mechanized arm. Oh shit. There we have some enemies, we can't go through them, we need to go around them. Otherwise they might surround my general and kill him. Here we have some bruisers. AI controlled. Our friendly ally. Allied AI.
The enemy are badly
blocked. The goblin faction was entirely lag free in this view. I guess they are very numerous, the goblins, and also the Kiraji too, so that's probably why, and the moodles are a good quality as well. But yeah, they are very numerous, the Kiraji and the goblins. The game used to crash sometimes because they were too numerous, the goblins. That's why I had to lower their numbers from the maximum number. I believe the cameras have been on too many at once, it will crash, but I don't think it will happen when you have the tool, the medieval tool and the overall project tool. Without the tool it would crash, just like with the Giants. Here we have some goblin bruisers. Fighting the Kiraji over there. See the battle here. Quite a few still remaining. Killed 81% and killed 13%, so we are clearly winning. We still have quite a few alive. Seems to take some time to kill them off. Need to avoid our own cannonballs. There is friendly fire in the game, so we can be killed by our own cannonballs if we're unlucky. It's realistic in that sense. Here we have some tail gunners. Our worst gunners. No, they are not gunners. I thought they were. More of those guys. There we have the tail gunners. The guy in pistols.
Praise to our Lord! Our men have slain the enemy general. Now his men will lose heart.
Looks like we have won almost. The slimes are dead. Our numbers are far from dwindling. They have some units left, but not many. Some of the silhouetted crawlers are still alive. Here we have some other units. Silhouetted Ravagers and the Silhouetted Swarmers. Alright, so the battle went well. We didn't expect any other result. We had total numerical advantage. So we killed 94%, we killed 15% of our troops. So the Kiragi can become a problem in the late game because they have so many troops. Hopefully we can kill off the trolls before that happens. Alright, the battle seems to be over. Here we have some rebels, goblin rebel, our militia. First unit in our army.
Great, my lord.
Battle is over.
We have lost control of the city.
No, we lost control. 5% enemies killed, 15% allies killed. We have won the battle. For some reason we lost the city center. Kirai faction is a swarming faction. They have even more numbers. Here we have some, I believe, tail gunners in melee. Look like pirates almost. They also firing their guns. Fire at once.
All of Christendom,
and we won the battle. Awesome. Good job, goblins. So we won the battle and took Shimmering Flats. The council wanted. Clear victory. Big goblin in the trade coalition. So it's probably the leader or the heir. So we had 78 men deployed, we lost 0 of the bodyguard, and everyone remained, we killed 0 too. Captain Reghi, who's of the trade coalition, had 3,778 men deployed, he lost 434, and we have 2,644 remaining. Killed 1145 and 26 additional enemies were killed when they were broken. Guest, the Orc, had 1171 men, lost all of them, killed only 473. Pretty poor job from the Kiragi there, but they weren't at an advantage. Okay. You brought much suffering to the world, Ildan. For that you can never be forgiven. However, you saved the life of my love. For that I will let you go, Melfurion Stormrage, Archdruid. So we won the battle. This settlement has fallen to the might of your army. Victory is yours, and the fate of the settlement lies in your hands. We can just walk in, Florence gains from looting 0. We can bang a few heads, we're playing to be massacred 6, we gain 0 from looting, and let them have it, we gain 0 from looting and massacre 6. Let's just let them have it, that will reduce the chances of revolt, okay, and then we will exit this. We need to do that after every battle when we've used it, otherwise it will bug out in the next battle. Okay, so we will enter the village with army, merge the troops, enemy army routes, big goblin trade collision. Okay, the big goblin is here. Mission success. We have been rewarded with 2,500 florins. We got some money. Okay, resistance is futile in Shimmering Flats. Trade increase. Big goblin of trade collision. Mean leader. Yeah, we exterminated the Kiraji insects in Shimmering Flats to reduce the likeliness of revolts. So we have two areas. We need to move the army back to Gadgetzan.
Yes? Yes.
Because the trolls are a danger there. We can't really do it this turn. We'll do it next turn. Okay, I think we have moved already.
Yes.
Yeah, next turn. Alright, another turn.
Yes, can
this embark with this army? Can join the other fleet.
Yes,
this fleet can also join.
Merging with fleet.
We have a fourth fleet somewhere. Let's move them as
yes.
Well. Down here.
Dropping anchor until the order.
And these ships too.
Combining the fleets.
Oh, they reached the entire bay there. Here we have some trolls. We have Xento, the general. Their units are the Gurbash primitives, their militia. We have some troll axe throwers, their worst missile unit. We have the troll spears, basic spearmen. We have some Gurbash headhunters, they are pretty good. We have lean throwers, and then we have troll archers, they are decent. We have troll warriors, just the bodyguard. Bad bodyguard. Okay, let's assault the city. Could attack, but I want to wait on the rest of the army. We have four more units arriving.
Orders.
And
yes, the orders. Yes.
This ship can move back. Can use another unit in the army. The hobgoblin. And can recruit something. So we can recruit goblin rockets and the trike gangs in undermine Gaggis, and we can go for a goblin rabble. Have a look, we can also go for a goblin rabble. And in Ratchet as well. Mads Proget. Don't need one in Boot Bay or in the other area. Here we have a General Hartford. Oh, there are three generals here. Elsington, Shrelly, and Hartford. They have combined into one army. They might attack me. We'll defend. They do. I'm more worried about the recon. Okay, recruitment report. We have some hobgoblins and sappers and some goblin infantry. End of turn report, same as before.
Yes. Yes.
Okay, what about my agent? I had a diplomat somewhere. Use for him right now against the rebels. Let's just click end turn. Start are under siege. Settlement besieged. Gadgets and... Shit. I forgot to move the army here.
Orders? Yes. Yes. Crossing
the army is hurrying up. I should have moved them the last time. I forgot about it. Too bad.
Orders. March. We march no further.
Okay. So in Shimmering Flats we can convert them to Bailey. We'll do that. And the army won't be able to reach this time. Enemy army. And so heavy sanctuary extras and leader has Frankie champions but got an elite unit. Check their entire army. Can do that. They have Sanctuary Nomad Hunters, Javeliners, Sanctuary Axe Throwers, Sanctuary Nomad Bowman. It's not their best Bowman, it's their basic one. Sanctuary Zombies. It's a really bad unit, but it has unlimited morale, it's a zombie unit. Sanctuary Nomad Spearman, it's zombie trolls. And we have Sanctuary Warriors, basic troops. Mounted Sanctuary Nomad Spearman. Some basic medium cavalry or basic cavalry. They have one elite unit, the bodyguard. Won't attack them, they will attack us. Relations report, very poor with the Frack Trolls, the Garbage Trolls and Ankarai. Relations improved, a good relations with the Terramore faction. Recruitment report, we have a Goblin Rabble in Mad Sprocket Ratchet, they have a look at Gadget San. We have a construction report. In all cities we have a letter to near, so there are the units have better armor. Faction announcements, the retinue expands, right. End of turn report, same as before. Second besiege Gadgetzan, yeah. They will probably take Gadgetzan, we will have to take it back. I fucked up. We won't destroy any buildings. Okay, so we can probably attack here too. Our army is ready.
Your orders, number one. It is an honor to lead these armies.
Okay.
Yes,
we're sending another unit.
Yes. Joining our fleets, my lord.
Okay. All of these troops can just besiege for now. Recruit anything in Shimmering Flats. Gadgetzan is under siege. Have a look, we can build something. We'll go for vendor stalls here. Same in Ratchet. I think we can go for a swine herder. A traveler's lodge in Mad Sprocket. We're back in Boot Bay. Let's go for some vendor stalls in Venture Bay as well. The gadgets and we can't do anything, okay. And turn. They didn't attack, good. Start turn. End of turn report, same as before. Recruitment report. We have Goblin Rockets and the Trike Gangs in Undermine the capital. This army is now ready for a unit. Okay, we can attack because we had a cannon. Let's move the cannon out of there. Move this unit into the army then. Okay, hostility ceased. Kingdom Stromguard and the Dark Irons. Made a truce. Relations improved with the Horde, with good relations. Construction report. So in Undermine we have a crafter's workshop and Booty Bay we have a fighting grounds completed.
Orders.
The army finally reached the outskirts of Gadgetzan.
Yes.
including the cannon. Now we can actually sally out. Good, we will attack the trolls. Trade coalition 2. I have 2 saves. Okay, we can't control them. Yeah, battle like this. Fight the battle on the battle map. You have brought much suffering to the world, Ildan. For that you can never be forgiven. However, you saved the life of my love. For that we'll let you go. Furion Stormrage, Archdruid. I already read that. Okay, start battle. So we have, you know, defenses here. The village of the Horde is used for, by the large town or town as well. I believe it's the town. Here's our army. No, this is the Faraki. I thought they have goblin rabble. Yeah, they are probably mercenaries. So they have some goblin mercenaries too. Trolls. Here's their general. Seem to either be retreating or moving towards our army. Our army is coming over here. Death dealers. Female goblins, assassins type, ninjas or assassins. Have some heavy infantry, some hobgoblins. Bombard, tail gunners. So the balance of forces is evenly matched.
It seems to be swinging in our favor. From such tidings does victory emerge.
Can send out our rebels, but we won't do it yet. We'll do it when our army has reached the front. Now I think they can have used guard mode on. The captain is a rebel. You can place the goblin infantry in field wall formation. We also have some pirates, they are mercenaries too, consisting of goblins, dwarves and dark iron dwarves. They are gunners, swords and melee. Of course they had some bombers and rebels too, so they are mercenaries in these areas. Here are their zombie trolls, sanctuary zombies. They are really slow. Have some bowmen. Axe throwers. And headhunters. Spearmen. The elite bodyguard unit. Frag champions. Warriors, shields and axes, such. Our army is soon here. So let's see UI options. This can be on slide. Let's make them shoot out first against the enemy. Empty their ammunition. Tail gunners. We'll fight a few of them. Some goblin bruisers there. They're two-handed maces. The upon them, let's fast forward. Victory is a distinct possibility, that's good. Quality of our troops are better than theirs. We have more elites, we have at least two. And more medium troops than they have. They have more basic troops. Goblin Death Stealers, Hobgoblins, Bodyguard. Bruisers. Here we have the general, one of the generals. They have like three generals in the army. Mostly adopted generals. No real general. Let's slow down. I wanted them to shoot out. Okay, let's order our own wordless rabble to attack. Can attack their bombards. Selling out as well. There are two units of Goblin Rebel and one unit of Goblin Infantry. The Hobgoblin Bodyguard has reached the Fraki Zombies. They are being fired at by the Fraki Axe-throwers. Their Pirate Musketeers are firing their muskets. Muskets against us, but we also have some firepower. Tail gunners. They had mostly long range units. Zoom in on the map so you can see better here. 9% enemies killed, 11% allies killed. Okay. So our troops have soon reached the enemy. Have another bodyguard. So Goblin Rebel have really bad morale. They will probably rout. Goblins versus goblins here. It's looking good. 17% enemies killed, 19% allies killed. In their cavalry here. Mounted sand fury noble spear.
The battle is in our favor. If we remain true and
I think they are both throwing javelins and using axes in the melee. Our goblin rabble are already winded. These are their raptor mounts. Here we have a tinker unit, one of the elite units. Using its giant mechanical arm. fight in melee. Bombers versus bombers.
Our army is tiring.
Right. So the trolls actually hire some goblins to fight for them. I don't know how to disable mercenaries for certain factions. But if I add mercenaries, they will be available to anyone, even the undead or the insects. Okay. I know it's possible to disable them, like Undead Nephilim did in Heroic War. Here we have some goblin bruisers fighting the Afraki champions. They are getting slaughtered. With 10 left here. There's a clear disadvantage there. The goblins are clearly smaller than the dwarves. You can see that here.
Thrown his life away, and perhaps our chances of victory with it.
Should be about the same size as the gnomes. Noble death, so one of our captains died. Captains doesn't matter anyway. Only generals matter. We have the captain of our unit. He seems to be dead, yes, I can't send the horn anymore. Okay. Yeah, the rebel is really bad.
Only half the enemy force remains.
Bad morale and doesn't do much damage either. Unfortunately, they too had some rabble in their ranks. So we disabled this bomber, that's good. Here are some pirates. Still have a bombard here. We have one unit still fighting. The goblin infantry. The rest have routed already. One of the rebels have been taken out and the other one is routing. Only 37 remaining. We have 122 goblin infantry. Fighting this rebel here. We win that fight. So we have killed 56% and killed 69%. We might lose the battle. Lose Gadget's. Then we'll have to retake it later. We still hold Shimmering Flats, but we can't recruit there.
The battle seems to have turned against us. We must act and halt this turn of events.
They're still shooting out. Seems like the battle is lost here. Maybe I should retreat my troops from Venture Bay in Mortrend and try to retake Gadgetzan instead. I'd rather hold Kalimdor and, because I believe the Vreekin will be too much of a challenge. Could probably fight everyone else in Mordred, but not the Vreekin, they are too big for our early melee troops.
Our men are fleeing the battle.
After defeat, our army is defeated. Their ally is still fighting. We have killed 63%, we killed 77%. We seem to be losing. Here is our bombard, he's still firing.
Our ally's general lies dead, slain by the enemy. We must help his men avenge him, lest they lose the heart.
Seem to be losing time. Yeah, we need to send the army from Venture Bay here. Rather hold Kalimdor and hold an area in Mordred. We have no goals in Mordred anyway. We'll obviously be defeated sooner or later. So they still have their legion in the Thraki, champions, bodyguard, and their general. Killed 84% of our troops now. We lost big here. It's good for our economy that we lost some troops. So these guys are broken. Bombard now. Our goblin bombard crews are shaking. Yeah, they will win. 70%, 87%. Right, we lost the battle. Their sanctuary axes are still throwing their axes. Their javeliners throwing their javelins. Our troops are routing towards the city, I say. Where they will be slaughtered in a last stand. Winter center. Easily. Got our infantry there. All right. javeliners are pretty long range. They have really good long range units, the trolls. So the night elves, they used to be trolls. So it makes sense. High elves, the blood elves used to be night elves, and Naga used to be night elves as well, so all of them used to be trolls once. Well, the humans are the sons and daughters, the bastard sons and daughters of giants, the Greek. Let's fast forward, it takes forever. So we have kill 74%, kill 91%. So here comes the trolls towards the center, let's slow down. We're now closing in on the center. Gadgetzan. Not much of a town. Maybe the city should be more evolved in the Frozen Throne. Might change some of the settlements and make them more expanded or evolved in the Frozen Throne campaign. Now they are busy slaying all the tail gunners here. Other units on their way. You have their general. Trolls are huge compared to the goblins. Right, we lost 94%, we lost 76%. I killed some of our troops with their ranged units. I attacked this too late. Attack the bodyguard. So we have unlimited morale inside of this plaza. They will all fight with death.
Only intervention by the Almighty Lord, or a military genius, can bring us victory from this disgrace.
A line of goblin infantry there. I am controlling them. Then charge, what are you doing? So they are under AI control, it won't change much, but thought they might do better like that. Gadgetzan is lost. derive some allies. Goblin tail gunners.
Holy Mother, save us! Our enemy is in control. Good news.
All our infantry is no longer in command of the city. Almost gone. There's some infantry here too. Allied infantry. Right, so the gunners will fire again. They have total superiority in this battle. Our troops suck in comparison. Gadgets and 99% allies killed. Here we have some allies, but they are broken, so we will probably lose before they reach the plaza of the town. We have 10 left. One goblin tail gunner. He died there. Taking out the before they reach the plaza with their javeliners.
May the Lord Almighty have mercy on our souls. Our foe's victory could not be greater.
Oh, one left. Okay, crushing defeat. Captain Donais had 522 men, lost all of them, killed 242. It was bad. The big goblin in the trade coalition had 2,571 men, lost 2,568, lost almost all of them, only three remaining, killed 1,457, and one when they were routing. And to Sul, the general of the Ferrucan Trolls, had 2,273 men, so they were at a numerical disadvantage. They lost 1,538 men or trolls, and they have 735 remaining. Okay, so they killed 2,937 and 148 were broken. So their army were clearly superior. We lost the leader, or I believe that it was the leader, and we also lost the town. Now Shimmering Flats is in danger. Let's accept. Alright, the noble death, big goblin in the trade coalition. New faction air. Ah, it was the air that died. Settlement occupied. He got good sand. Alright. Let's build training grounds in the Shimmering Flats. Also, we're about to attack here. Well, I think we could do that. To get another outpost. Okay. I will let the AI control. Fight the battle.
Seems to be swinging in our
way. Wait.
From such tidings does victory emerge.
Start deployment. We have a bomber, I believe, a goblin bomber. Let's lose formation. Place it there. Start battle. Attack their gate. They have very weak gates. Since a wooden palisade, it will be easily broken. Opened up by our bomber. Best at hitting the target. This is a troll village or town. Probably town. Giribashi. Rebel town. Seems to be a mix between Giribashi and a mani troll. Allies moving around. Okay. Still haven't reached the gate. Let's move forward. Move forward, you missed too much. If we run out of ammunition without destroying the gate, they will win the battle. Let's fast forward. They had anything that could destroy the gate. Here we have their shredders. Makes trade collision. Don't like that the mechs are in the way. Fuck. Idiot. Stop firing.
The battering ram has done its work.
Ah, battering ram. Good. Our ally managed to breach the gate over here. Now they will swarm the city. Fight their troops. First they'll fight the troll spears. I won't bother playing any strategic battles manually. until it's actually a challenge. I mean, against the rebels in the start of the campaign, it's not really necessary. And I didn't expect the Feraki army to attack. I will control them manually when we're trying to retake it, probably. Take gadgets and... Hopefully we'll win against the trolls over here. Have another ram here. This ram, by the way, is shared with the horde. Probably the dark horde. The darker and the worst, probably. At least the two horde factions. Disappointed that the cannon didn't even manage to hurt this place. Guys are pretty cool. Firing at us, that's from the side. These troll archers. Right, it's looking pretty good. I need to go and drink after this battle. I did a mistake of not having any water nearby. I want to move a fleet from Venture Bay. Maybe also move this army to Gagdensan first. Let it fight there. First wave. Here are some goblin death dealers. Many of them. Seems to have one here. They're now spreading out throughout the city. Here are more of the Death Stealers. They are good. Despite their small size.
Only half the enemy force remains.
They seem to be being... seem to be losing. Reinforced by the hobgoblins and the goblin bruisers. There are more of our troops fighting here. Troll spearmen. not too good at the goblin tail gunners are used melee. That's not good. Trolls are the main enemy of the trade coalition.
We are blessed. The enemy general is dead. We have sent the
kill the general. Enemy general fall. Except him. The rebels. Balance of power. So we lost 16%. They lost 82%. We are winning this battle. Really. X-Troids are still throwing their axes. So we have won the melee fight over here. And they have hit large numbers. Ready to stomp those X-Troids. There are too few to stop us. Even if their troops are better quality. For the most part. Oh, there's some archers here. Now our hobgoblins are stomped. Seems the shredders have moved. We can start firing.
Have taken control of the city. Curses! Our men no longer command the city.
Still no damage on the gate. They are bad at hitting the target. Trolls are now surrounded here. The shredders have entered too.
My lord! Our men have taken control of the city!
Yeah, we've won the battle. Right, 100% enemy killed, so the two left, one remaining. Savory. And it died. We won, we took the city.
This is a clear victory that goes to only men of great virtue and valor.
All right, clear victory. Captain Sickle of the Trade Coalition had 41 men, lost 0. 41 remaining, 0 killed. Caesar Ginvistel had 2741 men, lost 428, and have 2313 remaining. And he killed 845 men and hit 9 additional men when they were broken. XN2 of the rebel trolls had 950 men and lost 950, 0 remaining, killed 501. Okay. Alright, we're down. You've been a loyal friend, Kel'Thuzad. I don't know what the future holds or if I'll even return, but I want you to watch over this land. See to it that my legacy endures. Artis Menethil, Death Knight. Alright, let them have it. Took another ISO. No buildings here. Let's enter the city. Leave a general here. Move out the cannon. Board the ships. Go towards the guide, get sand. Alright, let's build dirt roads there. She took a town, Telabim. Here we can build a port. Recruit some new troops, strike gangs, and a goblin artificer. In Boot Bay we can go for, maybe we can go for a port in Boot Bay. Right, we can go for another goblin infantry unit. Everlook, we can go for a goblin infantry unit as well. Okay, we can't recruit anything in Shimmering Flats or in Tel Abim. Adventure Bay, we don't need anything. We want to evacuate them there. Booty Bay. Maybe we can go for Goblin Infantry. Nah, we don't need anything there. Mud's Procket, we have a full garrison now. Don't really want anything there either. Alright, what about the ships? Let's move this fleet towards Venture Bay. This is as far as we go, yes. Alright, so in total our fleet is a full-sized force. We have these four ships away, we will move them towards Venture Bay.
Yes.
Okay, enter. Another general in undermine. Okay, we can recruit something. Goblin infantry. Okay, we can go for another drinker unit and the unit of sappers, maybe. Okay, in Tel Abim, we can go for a unit there for a building, the training grounds, so we can get some troops. Shimmering Flats. I think we want a village. Rather than a castle. Alright. Goblin infantry would be good as well. move the troops back there. Oh, we didn't get to defend, I think. Defensive battles do not work in this hot seat, and we will end the campaign. I don't like playing when I can't fight defensive battles. So if that doesn't work, we will have to exit the campaign, and I will have to edit the settings for multiplayer hot seat, because that's not intended. Of course, you're supposed to be able to defend in hot seat. It's always worked before, I don't know why it wouldn't work now. Must have changed the settings somehow. As we didn't get to fight the battle with that force that was here. So I believe the defensive battles do not work all of a sudden. That means in the release, you can't fight defensive battles in hot seat. That's certainly not intended. They used to work, so. Still to seize King of Stormbird and the Scourge, they were made of trees. Recruitment report. So, Goblin Warlocks in Undermine and Goblin Artificers, and in Ratchet, you have a Goblin Infantry unit in Everlook, you also have one. The turn report. Okay, steps before. Okay, instruction report. Well, we have some vendor stalls, swine herders, etc. Sucks if I can't play defensive battles. The reason I play the hot seat campaign and not a single player is because I like using certain console commands that are only possible to use in hot seat. But I'm supposed to be able to fight defensive. I don't know why it has been deactivated. Very weird. I think it's deactivated.
Yes.
The fleet is moving ever closer to Everloon.
The order.
All right, the capital. Alright, we are recruiting some goblin rabble. Where did I recruit that? Yeah, in Everlook, that's fine. Don't need one in Ratchet. Or in Mud's Progate. Or in Booty Bay. So this is a Gerbashi priest outside of Booty Bay. Okay, we need no one in Venture Bay either. The Scarlet Crusade is still done. Alright, next time. Start turn. Guild available, Explorer's Guild, okay. End of turn report. Construction report, we have some port and Booty Bay and Undermine. Recruitment report. Yeah, Strike Gang Undermine, Tinkers in Undermine, Goblin Rabble in Everlook, and the Goblin Infantry in Shimmering Flats. Okay, the Armani and the Kingdom of Stormguard have made a truce. Let's build a ship right. Oh, I don't need that, we can get the submarines. Build the ballista towers, maybe no, we'll build a siege workshop. Shimmering Flats, we can upgrade the Mutant Bailey. Maybe I should have gone to the castle, we'll do that. And in Everlook, we'll go for another Goblin Rabble unit. Swine herder. Vendor stalls in Ratchet. Swine herder in Mud's Progate. Booty Bay, we could go for a crafter's workshop. And in Enter Bay, we can go for a traveler's lodge. Right, we're down there. City here, Rebel City, Lost Trigger Co. held by bandits, but we want to attack bandits and pirates. We want to attack Gaggins and the full force, full might of that force. Move the ships up to ever Venture Bay there.
Your orders, number one. Yes!
Alright, let's move most of the army.
Yes, my lord. This is as far
still
as
the left one goblin rabble in Venture Bay. Let's recruit some goblin infantry there. And in Underman, you can recruit some trike gangs. Let's pocket some goblin infantry. Booty Bay, we can go for some goblin submarines. Okay. Here we have a Gerbash priest. Report. Same as before, construction complete, training grounds, recruitment report. We have sappers in Undermine, in Madsbrocket we have goblin infantry, in Everlook we have goblin rabble, and in Venture Bay we have goblin infantry, and in Booty Bay we have a goblin submarine.
Yes. Moving ashore, my lord.
Alright, let's move ashore. Oh, we have a Terramor army here. Advisor Tervosh, an ally. They have water elementals. Human footmen. Human pikemen. Medium troops. They have a bodyguard of Terramor Archmagi and an elite unit. Really dangerous elite unit. He has a unique custom model, Tervosh. Khadgar from Warcraft 1. Do we have any cavalry? Oh, I can start a battle between Terramor and the others. Let's do that. Fuck, I couldn't attack. Back to that army then. So we'll see what Terramor will do. We're far away from Terramor itself. Okay, I think we can click next turn. Turn report. Okay. Still on number 3 military. Okay. We have some new buildings. Some new units. Still the Sea Stormwind and the Dark Horde. It's made a truce. A good relations with Terramore. They move down here to take this area. We want to fight the trolls.
March! Command! Your order, number one. Yes! It is an order to name thy enemy for you. We shall see. Your order, number one. Of course, I will let me strike.
Alright, new battle. The enemy has Thrakir Shadowblades, that's assassins. They are pretty good elite unit. Sanctuary Warriors, pretty good medium unit. They have some Sanctuary Archers, medium archers. They are decent. They have some Goblin Bombers. Okay. And Sul again. Teeth Army. Okay, save the game. And the army battle. Let's fight the battle on the battle map. We'll take vengeance for the last defeat at the hands of this general. It annoys me that I can't play defensive battles. So this is just a trial campaign. It's not a campaign that I will probably finish. I will play for now and exit and won't return it. Start deployment. Okay, start the battle.
Enemy are bringing in reinforcements.
Reinforcement, big goblin in the trade collisions or Ares in the battle. Here I have the enemy. Troll warriors. Troll archers.
Battle seems to be swinging
and these
in
shadow blades. Thrakir shadow blades.
Does victory emerge?
Will be the assassin on the map too. For the Thrakir trolls. Our army is approaching, entering the area of the battlefield. Here we have some elite units. Goblin artificers, really good gunners. Haven't seen them before. Action. More of the Goblin Rabble and Goblin Tail Gunners and the Goblin Brisiers. The Goblin Bombers. Goblin Infantry. The Hobgoblin Bodyguard, the general. Let's place them on shootout. Here we have the Shredders. Here we have our general. So I control one of the two generals. What are they doing? They're just standing here. Moving in with one unit here. More than one unit. Here's the general. The Thrakir Champions Bodyguard. Thank you. Alright, let's fast forward. Not the time to wait. Defensive battles do not work in the hot seat. It has something to do with saves and such. Very weird that it happens. So they need to hurry up. Troll armies are also becoming larger. Here comes some reinforcements. Some goblins. Reinforcements in the far back. Yeah. Wonder if they will be able to enter the battle or not. Probably not. So this will be the final battle before I end it for today. I might come back or I might not. Depends on what I feel like. In fact, defensive battles do not work. Kinda ruined it to some extent. That will need to be fixed. Maybe I even restart it. Replay everything without recording after fixing that. Maybe I just play the single play campaign where it works. But it should work in hotseat too. Archers have started to fire. Cannons from our bombers have started to fire upon them. So.
Only half the enemy force remains.
Alright, so the battle started, good. Melee has started between the goblins and the trolls. The shredders.
Only half the enemy force remains.
Shredding them there. Here we have some traitor goblins that sold their services to the enemy.
to our lord. Our men have slain the enemy general. Now his men will lose heart.
Killed 50%, we killed 16%. Clear victory this time. We had total American advantage. Let's fast forward. I'm too tired to get any of this.
We're 11 of the
death dealers. It's just a cap. So those troll warriors are broke. Shredders is fighting their shadow blades. They have some cool animations, they jump around like that. They are from the Warhammer mod, beginning of the end times. Battle against Frank Shadow Blades. Right.
Enemy general is dead. We have sent the idiot to hell.
Tussle is finally dead. Thank you. Alright, let's just hope it's over soon. Alright, end the battle.
This is a clear victory that goes to only men of
Troll, the blood is haze is lifted. Demon's fire is burned out in my veins. I have freed myself. No, old friend. You freed us all. Grom Hellscream and Troll. Oh, we have another Fraki army here. Fully sized great army. Shit.
We'll meet you there. Always. As my lord wills.
Alright. Fraki Abysmal. Okay, we have Abysmal relations with Fraki. Another great army approaching.
Darkest chief, come face me.
Including Sanctuary Sea Lots, elite unit, Sanctuary Brown Blood Drinkers, another elite unit, zombies, Noble Spearmen, Axe Throwers, Mountain Noble Spearmen, Sanctuary Warriors, Sanctuary Noble Spearmen, Mountain Noble Hunters. Captain Exonisha here. He has 3 units of pirate musketeers. They're pretty good. They're melee and missile attacks. Not that good defense. Sanctuary Norman Bowman. Medium. Basic. They have a unit of bombards too. Fuck that. I should have saved. I lost 25 men, our ally lost no one.
Calling of the siege, my lord.
That's surprising.
Let me strike, my lord. Yes.
They didn't name lose the army. Okay. This has executed the frack, okay.
Yes. Yes, my lord. This is as far as we go today, Baron.
Alright. Build a leather tunnel in Tel Abim. Training grounds in Shimmering Flats. Never looking for pig farms. The ratchet we can go for some pig farms as well. Mad's broken, we can go for some. Vendor stalls and some swine herders in Venture Bay. Okay, we don't need units in Everlook or in Ratchet or in Mad's Proget, Winter Bay, etc. Venture Bay, we can go for some. This fleet can move ever closer. Still far away.
Dropping anchor until morning. Yes. Move
on. Alright, we filled arm with these two units. The bomber.
Turkish chief, come face me. Your orders, number one.
This army can move up to the troll army. Can also hire some pirates. Diplomat can be moved out. Speak to trolls. Accept your proposal. They got their map information and they got ours. They've taken Lungoro and Rebel Raptors. Right, still to see if the Garbashan Stormwind, they have a truce, still to see the Frack and the Dreadgoblin, yeah. Recruitment report, we have Goblin Infantry in Elabim, Goblin Artificer in Undermine, and the Spy in Venture Bay. Carolands, you're on turn 12 by the way. Mostly female Marika. She has a Sapper Spy. So recruit the unit of Goblin Infantry now.
Yes.
Okay, let's convert Shimmering Flats to a wooden castle. The bay could use a leather tenier. Okay, recruitment. Telebrim, we could use a couple of rebel units. Okay. Right, I will end it here. We will save the game. I've had an army here. Rebels are still hauling Razor Fan. Killbow Rebel General. You want Cat get sent back?
Name thy enemy, Lord. We shall send him to hell or worse.
Huge bomb here. Let's save again. All right, see ya.